Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at what are the new things that are added to version 8.82.0. The first thing that has been added is this required array keys. Before it was named as array keys, but at the end, if you look here in the pull request, then it is changed to or renamed to required array keys. We also have this array validation rule before, and we could pass here some parameters, but this required array keys is a little bit different than that of this one. Okay, now currently let's say there is this array data coming from the request, and we are validating this in the controller or using some validator request class. And what this array said was, whatever the data that is present in the request, if it had any one of these keys, then it will pass. So currently we have A, B, C, D, E, and in the request data has A, B, and C, which means that among these data, this is present. So it will pass. So let me just comment it, the second one, and just reload. It is passing. It is showing the data because this validator will return the validated data as an array. So this is passing. But let's say we did something like Z over here like this. And here let's say value like this, and we just reload here, then it will throw an exception because this Z is not present over here. Okay, so this was kind of behavior that we get before, but now there is this new rule added, required array keys, which means that whatever we add over here, all of these keys must be present over here. Currently we have ABC, and here also we have ABC, and just reload, everything is passing. But let's say now I add over here Z, then this key is not present over here, so it will throw an exception. So whatever we write here must be present over here as a key. Okay, now let me comment this out. And the second thing that has been added is this cross join sequence for factories. Let's say whenever you are generating some data for the test using factories, then you could do it by using sequence. So let me show you that before. So before, let's say we wanted to generate first name and last name like this. So this Thomas Anderson, Thomas Smith, Agent Anderson and Agent Smith, then we had to do it like this before, okay? And we were generating four users here. So I'll just reload here. And you can see here one user, this Thomas Anderson, Thomas Smith, and here you can see here Agent Anderson and Agent Smith. These four users were created, and look at here, we had to write it in this way. But now there is this new cross sequence method. So let me just show you over here, this cross join sequence, this method, and we can write it like this. Now here we can get the four combination, but let's say we want more combination from here, then we can just add another, let's say, let me just pull it to the right like this. And let's say you want six users to be generated, then you need to write here just another last name over here, and it will create six users. It will have the ability to create six users, but whatever the value you write over here, it will create that many users, okay, with this combination of all the values that is available here. And again, if I just come here and reload, it will give us the same results. But let's say you only want two users over here, then it will only give us two users. And if you see here, okay, here Thomas Anderson and Thomas Smith, it is taking this Thomas Anderson and Thomas Smith. And let me comment it out. And the third thing that has been added is this transliterate shortcut for the str helper. So let me show you that also here. What it actually does, it converts these special characters into their corresponding alphanumeric characters. So let me just run this. You can see here it is changed from this to this A, B, C, D, E, F, G like this. And similarly, if we just write here 0, 1 like this, then it will convert this to the number. And in this third example, we don't know what this is. So in this case, it will just do question mark. And suppose let's say in case of question mark, you want to display something else, then you can just pass it like this over. Let's say we want to display dash over here, then it will just so dash in case of the unknown special characters or emojis. And why do we need this? Let's say you are making a login system, and whenever user logs in and they enter the wrong password multiple times, and let's say you have added a limit, let's say a user can only input the wrong password 5 times, then you will just block that user for, let's say, for an hour, so that they will not be able to enter the email and password again, because some third person might be trying to log in into someone else's account. And whenever you say save this data in a MySQL, then it will automatically convert this into transliterate, which means whenever it is comparing, like let's say ABC like this here, abc@gmail.com like this, if this string is saved in the database, then it will save as ABCD @gmail.com. So MySQL will automatically convert it, and whenever it is checking where condition also, it will automatically do that. But in case of PHP string, it will not do that. And let's say a user tried to log into the email by just doing, let's say, this abcd@gmail.com and using the wrong password, then let's say the limit has reached 10 limit. And again, the user can just try like this abcd@gmail.com by passing this value in the email, then the limit will again start from the beginning, because this abcd@gmail.com is not equal to this abcd@gmail.com in the PHP end, but it is same in the MySQL. So this will be very handy to prevent the brute force attack whenever we are creating the login system.